美国众院议长麦卡锡和所有跟蔡总统会谈的议员在雷根总统图书馆对记者说明今天对话的重点。议员表示，他们是跨党派的严肃看待对台湾的承诺，包括军售及时的交付台湾，加强经济合作，特别是科技和贸易领域，以及在国际间倡导共享价值。对于访问台湾的可能，麦卡锡说目前没有计划，重申中国没有权利决定他去哪要见谁。另外被问到如果中国入侵台湾，美军会不会介入，麦卡锡说他们现在所做的就是不要让这些假设性问题成真。我们来听听麦卡锡的说法。
Now, if there were a Chinese attack, do you think the American people would be okay with America sending troops or really stepping in to defend Taiwan? Thank you.
That's a hypothetical question that we never want to get to. The reason why we're together here with both parties sitting down is because we never want to see that question really get asked. We never want to see that to come to fruition.
Taiwan deserves to be free. Taiwan's people deserve freedom.
I told President Tsai that the House Democrats will never abandon this relationship and will work hand in glove with the Biden administration to affirm our commitment because we understand the unique role and vital role that Taiwan plays in the region.
议长麦卡锡和台湾总统蔡英文在美国领土见面，除了历史性意义之外，更重要的是展现美国两党两院对台湾是一致的团结支持。那么民主党众院党团主席艾吉拉的发言也代表了民主党方向。在蔡总统和麦卡锡会谈之后，前众院议长裴洛西也发声明指出，今天会谈展现的领导力、跨党派参与以及卓越的历史性地点都是值得赞赏的。 TVBS 新闻，嘉辉，美国洛杉矶报道。
想看最完整的新闻内容，记得下载 TVBS 新闻网 APP。